Hi friends, good evening. Today, I just want to give a small update on Nifty and Bank Nifty because yesterday it closed below the Ichimoku cloud. So I thought of giving a small update. First, we'll go to the PPT and then we'll come back to the chat. Okay. So this is our weekly observation. For this week from today to Friday. Okay, so today there was a gap down, and from there it recovered. And actually Bank Nifty, if you see, it recovered exactly from 35,344, which is our second target in Bank Nifty for this week. Okay, so from here it went and closed exactly at 35,937. Actual close was 900 or something, but that's average closing. According to my closing, it is 35,937. If you see in the graph, it is 35,934. So 3 points here and there. That's okay. So it has taken a support from 35,344, and from there it moved to 35,937 and closed. And in between, it came down all the way to 35,721, which is our second number, which is this number, 35,721. And from there, it moved. But eventually, all the gains were given, from, 36,300 level. Now, it came all the way down and closed exactly at our number, which is 35,937. Okay, this is Bank Nifty. And coming to Nifty, I clearly wrote that 16,940 to 17,161 is no trade zone. It means we should not trade, which is because this is a very, very indecisive game between these two numbers. So that is why I said there is no trade zone. So I have clearly written buy only above 17,161 for the weekly targets and sell below 16,940. On a 15 minutes closing basis. So it has not closed below 16,940 on a 15 minutes closing basis. And from there, it closed somewhere around 17,111. Okay, so now I just want to show this in chart and I want to apply Ichimoku and see what happened today. Okay, so remember this number, okay, 17,161 in Nifty and in Bank Nifty, which is 35,344. Okay. Okay, first we will talk about Nifty, and today's Nifty high is 160.10. Our number is 70,161, exactly 1 point in Nifty. So it has not gone long based on weekly. Okay, so the high is only 17,160 and our number is 17,161. So there is no long as of now. Okay. And tomorrow, in case if it sustains 17,161 for 15 minutes, you can go for long with the stop loss of today's low, because today's low is also very, very important. But the problem is today's high and low is roughly around 400 points. And if you take Bank Nifty, it is more than 1,200 points. So it was a big fall. So now I'm not taking today's low into consideration. So my number stands still, which is 35,721, which is my the second monthly target. That is the number which I'm watching out for. Anything below that, I'll go for sale. Okay. And anything above in Nifty, anything above 161 based on weekly number, I will take a chance. But I've already sent you the weekly game changer number in the morning itself. So use that to trade only for tomorrow. Okay. On December 1st, I will give you monthly game changer number. We will use that number to trade for the entire month. Okay. So now Nifty is not touched our number, which is 17,161, and today's high is 17,160, which is 1 point. And Bank Nifty, if you go and see, this is the low today, which is 35,344, which is our second target. for the weekly, and today's low was 35,342. Okay, 2 points it went below that. Okay, and if you see, it is holding this 200 day SMA, which is this black color line, and this 200 day SMA is at 35,706. Okay, but our number is 35,721. Okay, so I will remove this number now. Maybe I'll change this to 35,721. And if you see the closing year, it is 35,934.7. And our number is 35,937. So I will mark that also here. 35,937. So it closed exactly there only. So these two numbers are holding combined with your 2200 day SMA. See, my according to me, my numbers are paramount important. After that only, I will go and check all these indicators. Okay. So these two numbers are holding as of now. And tomorrow, any close below 35,721 for 15 minutes, then we can go for a short trade. Okay. Till that time, please avoid any short in Bank Nifty as of now. Okay. We will use the monthly number from Wednesday. And coming to Nifty, okay, we'll finish this first. Okay. So now, first, it is closed below cloud for the last 2 days. Okay. But if you see the lagging span, it is still within the cloud. It means it is indecisiveness. Okay, the lagging span has to come out here or has to go up here so that there should not be any hindrance for lagging span to move above. So if you see on the upper side, obviously, you know, it will face a lot of resistance, here. Because there are so many candles, which give hindrance, plus, you know, baseline, conversion line, all will give hindrance. But if it goes below this red color line, which is the base of Ichimoku cloud, the number is somewhere around 35,636. Okay. Any close below 35,636, close below, the fall will aggravate. Okay. And if you see, the future Ichimoku cloud is already turned to bearish. Okay, so the conversion line is below the baseline. This red color line is the baseline, and the conversion line is the green color line, which is the upper part of the cloud, and it is below the baseline, which is not really looking good. Okay, so this is what I want to cover in Bank Nifty. And if you go to Nifty, and Nifty also, these two candles closed below the cloud, and lagging span is still not touched the upper part of the cloud. Possibility of taking support from the cloud, upper part, or if it goes below, then the indecisiveness will start. But once it breaks 16655, which is everybody is talking about, the extreme support, but our support number is here, which is 16641. So it is also combining with, Ichimoku cloud baseline. So if it goes below that, then the real problem will start. Then the next thing which we need to look out is 16,093 level. Okay. But I have already told you many, many times, anything below 17,351 itself, my first target is 15,625. Once below 15,625, my target on or before December 30th is 13,596. The market must close below 13,596 on or before 31st December 2021. And this was my prediction on January 1, 2021. Because based on the decade, my reading, the first year of the decade candle, which is 2021, must end in red. And as of the low of 2021 as of today is 13,596. So before on or before December 31st, it should close below 13,596. And again, I'm saying based on 573 days, maybe you all seen that video from where Nifty stopped out. This is on 18th, okay? From 18th was the 573 days, okay? From the, based on the calculation of 2006 to 2008 calculation. So this is the date. So from there only we started collapsing, and then we already lost roughly around 1,500 points, okay? So now, based on this reading, the target is 6564, okay? And it should happen on or before 22nd, 10, 2022, okay? I'm talking about October 22, 2022, okay? Let's watch. And that is roughly around 65% correction from the top, which is a big number. But let's watch how the market is going to react towards that number. But as of now, first we will go with the immediate numbers, which are 17,341, and the next number which we watch out is 15,625, and the second number we'll watch out is 13,596. So this is what I want to give an update. So as of now, as of today, Bank Nifty is holding 35,937, and Nifty is holding 16,940. So risk, everything I wrote in the PPT for tomorrow, maybe I'll show that. Okay, see, use these dates, you know, these dates will definitely give minimum 200 to, you know, 1 second. Okay, so use these dates for next month, which is December 6th, December 11th. So whenever the holiday is coming on December 11th, it means you can use the next trading day. And the major day is happening on 20th and 21st. And both are holidays this time, which is Saturday and Sunday. So the impact will be seen on... The impact will be seen on 22nd December. Okay. And the last month, all the 4 days, 5 days, which I mentioned, you know, it has given more than 250 points on the single day. I'm talking about the important dates. So this month, the important dates are December 6th, December 11th. I think December 11th is, it's working. No, December, just a minute. One minute. Both days are working. 20th is working, 21st is working, and 11th is holiday. Okay. So 11th is holiday. So you can take, this is as 13th. And 20th and 21st, okay, on December 20th and 20th. Okay, both are working. So you will see the impact on these days itself. So 21st is a mega day, and 20th also is combining based on some other working. So 20th and 22nd will be the game changer day for Nifty and Bank Nifty. Okay, so other dates I've given. So monthly game changer number I will give you on Wednesday around 10 o'clock, and as of now, you use this numbers to go long or go short in Nifty and Bank Nifty for the weekly. Those who want to follow Nifty spot, you follow Nifty spot. Those who want to follow Nifty future, follow Nifty future. Don't combine these two, and you know, because the difference is roughly around 50 points. So don't get into trouble. If you want to follow future, you follow only future. If you want to follow spot, you follow only spot. Suppose if you are buying at 36,302, keep the stop loss of 36,158. Very simple. If you're buying Nifty future 17,138, keep the stop loss of 752. Okay, 17,052. Okay, and tomorrow, very big day for Bharati. watch out. I'm expecting some good move in Bharati tomorrow based on the narrow CPR. And two more counters I identified for tomorrow, which are IRCTC and HDFC. Okay. In case if Bank Nifty is taking support from here, watch out for HDFC Bank, because so today HDFC Bank had a TCD. So the high was 1508 and the low was 1462. So you can buy above 1508 with a stop loss of 1462 on HDFC Bank. And NALCO, I am concentrating above today's high was 91.5. So buy above 91.5, stop loss is 86.3. And it is exactly at the trend line support. Maybe if you want, I can show that to you. No, then I need to open so many things. Okay, leave. It is holding the lower end of the trend line. So let's watch how it is going to behave tomorrow. And what is vice versa means? You can go for a short at 1462 and put a stop loss of 1508. So here also in NALCO, you can go short below 86.3 and the stop loss is 91.5. And just a minute. Okay, so tomorrow is the last day for November month. So the November month TCD, which is for tomorrow, is Bharati, I've already told you. And when it comes to December month, okay, so many companies are coming into combination dates. Okay, so including Reliance are coming into combination, NMDC, and my lookout is ICICI Bank, which is having two TCD, and the big one is Indian Bank. Indian Bank is having three TCD, one yearly, one blue, and one deep yellow. So maybe some big may happen in Indian Bank. That is what I'm expecting. But all these dates are coming at the end of the month, which is around from 21st it will start. And it ends at 30th December. So most of the stocks are coming at the end of the December. So the important stock to watch in December are Indian Bank, ICICI Bank, Reliance. Even Kotak Bank started moving today. I think LIC is taking some stake. I think they got the approval to increase the stake in Kotak Bank. That is why, that is the one stock which held Bank Nifty today. Otherwise, we would have seen a major downfall today. And HDFC was looking okay. And Bajaj Finserv is having a combination date. And nearest combination, I'm not getting any nearest combination dates, which is the closer one. All are little only. So first we will see. Okay, on second it is Pfizer. And on third it is HPCL, which is a blue color TCD. So please remember. And Berger Point on third. So we will watch these two. And idea I've already told, it is long about 10.3 and the stop loss is 10 rupees and today it closed at 11.2. Okay, let's watch. So I'll close the video today. So again, I'm saying I'm not a SEBI registered investment advisor. So kindly do your homework before investing in stocks or mutual funds. Thank you.